हाय हेलो, दिस इज गिरी टीचिंग 10th मैथमेटिक्स द चैप्टर स्टैटिस्टिक्स. हियर आर द क्वेश्चंस एंड सॉल्यूशंस फ्रॉम एक्सरसाइज 14.1 एंड दिस इज पार्ट 3 वीडियो. इन दिस वीडियो वी विल लर्न द सॉल्यूशंस ऑफ क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 एंड क्वेश्चन नंबर 6 ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 14.1. डियर चिल्ड्रन, दिस इज एक्सरसाइज 14.1 ऑफ द चैप्टर स्टैटिस्टिक्स एंड क्वेश्चन नंबर 5. फाइंड द मीन नंबर ऑफ ऑरेंजेस इन ईच बास्केट. आई शैल रिपीट. फाइंड द मीन नंबर ऑफ ऑरेंजेस इन ईच बास्केट. द टेबल इज नंबर ऑफ ऑरेंजेस एंड द नंबर ऑफ बास्केट्स. द फर्स्ट रो स्टैंड फॉर नंबर ऑफ ऑरेंजेस एंड द सेकेंड रो स्टैंड फॉर द नंबर ऑफ बास्केट्स. यू सी द नंबर ऑफ बास्केट्स कंटेन्स 10 to 14 ऑरेंजेस is 15, and the number of baskets which contain 15 to 19 oranges in each basket is 110, and the baskets which are containing 20 to 24 oranges is 135, and the number of baskets that contain 25 to 29 oranges is equal to 115, and the number of oranges 30 to 34 and the number of baskets is 25. This is the table or group distribution or group data given for us. For this group data, you have to find the mean or arithmetic mean. As we know that there are three types of measures of central tendencies. The first is arithmetic mean, second is median, and the third is mode. Understood? Arithmetic mean, median and mode, these three are called measures of central tendencies, out of which the first one is arithmetic mean, and this arithmetic mean can be found using three different ways. The first is direct method, the second is deviation method, and the third is step deviation method. If the classes and the frequencies are small in numbers, then you can use direct method so that the calculation may be easy. But whereas if the classes and the frequencies are big in numbers, then while calculation you may feel some difficulty in finding the product, and in finding the division also you may feel difficulty. In such cases you can adopt either deviation method or step deviation method. If you observe this table, understood the classes are small numbers whereas the frequencies are big in number. The frequencies are in hundreds. Therefore, let us adopt or let us use step deviation method to solve this. Understood? So, number of oranges can be considered as classes, and the number of baskets may be taken as frequencies. So, the first column is for classes. 10, 14, 15, 19, 20, 24, 25, 29, 30, 34. All these are classes. Now in 10 to 14 class, the frequency is 15. In 15 to 19 class, the frequency is 110. 20 to 24, the frequency is 135. 25 to 25, the frequency is 115. 30 to 34, the frequency is 25. These are the frequencies. Now after writing the frequencies, since you are finding arithmetic mean, the third column is for mid value or class mark. How to get mid value of a particular class? Mid value or class mark of the class is nothing but the average of lower and upper boundaries of the particular class. For example, if you are asked to find the mid value of 10 to 14 class, then you have to add both of them. What is 10 plus 14? 10 plus 14 is 24. 24 divided by 2 is 12. Similarly, 15 plus 19, the sum is 34, divided by 2 is 17. 20, 24, if we add these two, you will get 44. 44 divided by 2 is 22. 25 plus 29, 54. 54 divided by 2 is 27. 30, 34 is 64, divided by 2 is 32. These are the mid values. Understood? After writing the mid values, you may consider the mid value which is opposite to the highest frequency as A, or the mid value of the middle classes. Out of the five classes, the third class may be the middle class, so that you can take it as A. Of course, you can consider any of these mid values as A, no problem. You will get the same answer. Whatever the value you take as A, you will get the same answer finally. Okay, anyhow, we took this class mid value as A, that is 22 as A. This A stands for assumed mean. A stands for assumed mean. Okay, after the mid value column, the next column is for deviation. The formula to find deviation is di is equal to xi minus a. Di is equal to xi minus a. Xi means mid value or class mark, and a means assumed mean. You have to subtract assumed mean from mid value for each of the classes. If you consider this class, for this class mid value is 22 and a is also 22. Therefore, 22 minus 22 is 0. And for this class, mid value is 27 and a is 22. 27 minus 22 is 5. For this class, 32 is mid value and a is 22. 32 minus 22 is 10. Similarly, if you come to this class, here mid value is 17 and a is 22. 17 minus 22 is minus 5. And this is 12 and this is 22. 12 minus 22 is minus 10. These are deviation columns. After writing deviation di, next column is for ui. Ui is equal to di divided by h. H means the height of the class. Height of the class is nothing but the difference between any two successive lower boundaries or any two successive upper boundaries or any two successive mid values. The difference is always 5, therefore the height of the class is 5. So you have to divide all these values with 5. Minus 10 divided by 5 is minus 2. Minus 5 divided by 5 is minus 1. 0 divided by 5 is 0. 5 divided by 5 is 1. 10 divided by 5 is 2. These are ui values. Or in other words, corresponding to A, in ui column you write 0, and above 0 you write minus 1, minus 2, and below 0 you may write plus 1 and plus 2. This minus and plus may depend upon the classes. The classes are in ascending order, so you may get minus values above and plus values below. These values should also be in ascending order. Understood? After writing the frequencies and ui, now you have to multiply fi with ui and you have to write here. 15 into minus 2, minus 2 15 is minus 30. 110 into minus 1 is minus 110. 135 into 0 is 0. 115 into 1 is 115. 25 into 2 is 50. Now we add positive values. 115 plus 50 is 165. Add negative values. Minus 30 minus 110 is minus 140. What is 165 minus 140? 25. Therefore, sigma fi ui value is 25 and sigma fi is 400. The sum of the frequencies is 400. Now, let us write the formula to find arithmetic mean using step deviation method. As you adopted step deviation method, you write the formula for arithmetic mean using step deviation method. Am is equal to a plus sigma fi ui divided by sigma fi into h. Here a means assumed mean, which is equal to 22, and sigma fi ui is 25. Sigma fi ui is 25, not 40. Please correct it. It is 25. And sigma fi is 400. And h, height of the class, the difference between any two successive lower or upper boundaries, is 5. Now substitute these values. Am is equal to a plus sigma fi ui divided by sigma fi into h. 22 plus sigma fi ui is 25, but not 40, 25, divided by sigma fi is 400 into h, add to the class is 5. Understood? Now this is 22 plus 25 and 25 one time, and in 425 16 times. This is 5 divided by 16. Now if you divide 5 with 16, you will get 0.31. Therefore 22 plus 0.31 is 22.31. Arithmetic mean or the given data is 22.31. This is question number 5. Now dear children, let us solve question number 6. Here is the question number 6. Find the mean daily expenditure of the food of the households. I shall repeat. Find the mean daily expenditure of the food of the households. Here in this table, we have given the daily expenditure as classes and number of households as frequencies. You see, daily expenditure between 100 rupees and 150 rupees on food and the number of households is equal to 4. And the number of houses in which the expenditure on food is 150 to 200 is 5. And the number of households where the expenditure on food per day from 200 to 250 is 12 houses. And in between 250 to 300 number of households is 2. And in between 300 to 350 the number of households is also 2. This is the table given for us. In this table we can consider the daily expenditure as classes and the number of households as frequencies. You see, classes 100 to 150, 150 to 200, 200 to 250, 250 to 300, 350 to 350. These are the classes. Now corresponding to these classes, what are the frequencies? 4, 5, 12, 2 and 2. These are the frequencies. After writing frequencies, you find sigma fi first of all. Sigma fi means you add all of them. 4 plus 5 is 9. 9 plus 12, 21. 21 plus 2, 23. 23 plus 2 is 25. This is sigma fi, sum of the frequencies. The next column is for class mark. Class mark is nothing but the average of 100 and 150. 100 plus 150 is 250. 250 divided by 2 is 125. After writing the class mark of the first class, now you verify the difference between any two successive lower boundaries or any two successive upper boundaries. The difference is always 50. Therefore, you can add 50 to these classes one by one. 125 plus 50 is 175. 175 plus 50 is 225. 225 plus 50 is 275. 275 plus 50 is 325. These are the mid values. After writing the mid values, the next column is for deviation, DI. DI is equal to XI minus A. We took the mid value, the middle class as A, this 225 as A. For this class, A is 225 and XI is also 225. Therefore, 225 minus same 225 is 0. And for this class, mid value is 275 and A is 225. 275 minus 225 is 50. And for this class, 325 minus 225 is 100. And if you go up, this is 175 is mid value and A is 225. 175 minus 225 is minus 50. And for this class, 125 minus 225 is minus 100. These are the deviations. After deviations, the next column is for UI. How to get UI? UI is equal to DI divided by H. We already found H is equal to 50. Now you divide all these values with 50. Minus 100 divided by 50 is minus 2. Minus 50 divided by 50 is minus 1. 0 divided by 50 is 0. 50 divided by 50 is 1. And 100 divided by 50 is 2. These are UI values. Okay. Now FI into UI. Frequency into this UI, step deviation. 4 into minus 2 is minus 8. 5 into minus 1 is minus 5. 12 into 0 is 0. 2 into 1 is 2. 2 into 2 is 4. Now if you observe, I wrote positive values here in a row and negative values separately in the other row. Now if we add, first of all add positive values. sigma fi ui is equal to 2 plus 4 6 minus 8 plus 5 is 13. What is plus 6 minus 13? This is minus 7. Sigma fi ui is minus 7 and sigma fi is 25. Understood? Now after writing all the values in the table, now you can write the formula for arithmetic mean using step deviation method. The formula to find arithmetic mean is a plus sigma fi ui divided by sigma fi into h. Here a value, assumed mean value 225. Sigma fi ui value is minus 7. Sigma fi value is 25 and h value is 50. Am is equal to a plus sigma fi ui divided by sigma fi into h. A value 225 plus sigma fi ui value is minus 7 divided by sigma fi value is 25 into h is 50. Now this 25 and 50 two times. This is 225 plus minus 7 into this 20 and 50 two times. This is 225 minus 7 into plus 2 minus into plus minus 7 2 is 14. Now what is 225 minus 14? 225 minus 14 is 211. Therefore, arithmetic mean of the given data is 211. All the video links of introduction to this chapter statistics and the questions and solutions of exercise 14.1 are given in the description. You can click the video link and you can observe the previous videos. Thank you. Thank you, one and all.